Okay, so I'm going to jump into test lab now and give kind of a little example of how this would work in the software. So I have some data and I'll display it here quickly on a multi-trace display. So I've got some accelerometers and then I have two proximity probes and a key phaser sensor. So I'll show you my displacement sensors. And then I'll show you my TACO or key phaser channel. And so I've got some data where I've done a run up and a coast down. And you can see during the run up, I get these higher levels of vibration on my displacement probes, which probably indicates that we're passing through a resonance of this particular machine. But I'll take this data, I'm going to replace it in the input basket. I'll come to time data processing and say replace. And then I am going to check one thing in my data processing settings here. And then I can hop over to this rotor dynamics tab. This rotor dynamics analysis tool is new as of, I think, Test Lab 2021.2. It's available as an add-in to the software if you go to Tools Add-ins. And you find the Rotor Dynamics add-in, it requires 20 tokens. So here I select my key phaser sensor, I select my key phaser orientation, my sense of rotation, and then I have auto select XY transducer pairs on if you name your sensor such that it has basically the direction of the sensor, X, Y, and so on. We can auto select those sensors for you so you could analyze multiple X, Y transducer pairs at the same time. The way this works then is you resample the information into the angle domain, and I can take a measurement. I might say I want to perform an analysis on that run up. So I'm going to use my TACO as my tracking channel. And then I'll say I want to analyze this from 300 RPM to 2000 RPM, and I'll have a RPM increment of every 25 RPM. So basically for things like my orbit plot, my centerline plot, my polar plot, my full spectrum waterfall, I'll be calculating an orbit every 25 RPM. I'll be calculating a point on the polar plot every 25 RPM, and so on. I can also choose to cut some orders. So I'll do a first order calculation here, for example. I can then give this a run name and then select calculate. And then at the bottom, I have some feedback as to the process or what is occurring in the calculation. So I'm calculating my full spectrums and then the result is finished. Note that I can also do a slow roll compensation. But this slow roll compensation, essentially what it does is all equipment that we'll be measuring has imperfections or glitches on it. You know, it might not be perfectly circular. There might be some scratches on it and so on. And these will show up in our vibration measurements as noise, essentially. So with the slow roll compensation, you would record some data at a low rotational speed where there aren't really any dynamic forces at play. So there's no shaft vibration. All of the displacement that we're reading is essentially due to the glitch in the shaft. And then we subtract that from our dynamic measurement data. I will hop now back over to Navigator and we can talk about a couple of these plots. So, like before, I mentioned our time-based plots. Here we can just see the vibration amplitudes of my two different proximity probes, my rotational speed. And I can also show this as a Bode plot, although here normally you would show the phase where I have filtered this vibration data. This is showing only vibration data at 1 times the rotating speed of the machine. And it looks here like I have two different shaft resonances. So I've got peak here at 1300 RPM and a peak here at 1550 RPM or so. And that's an indicator that I might have two resonances at these particular speeds. I can also look at my orbit plots, and what I have plotted here are orbits from different machine rotational speeds. So I've got something plotted from 300 RPM, something plotted from 1500 RPM, something from 1750 RPM, and something from 2000 RPM. So these are all showing just one cycle of the machine at that particular rotational speed. I have a shaft centerline plot here, so I can see, I'll add a cursor here to my rotational speed axis, and then if I highlight my curve, I can see, all right, at 300 RPM, this was the location of my shaft centerline, and then as I sped up the machine, I can see how and where my shaft centerline moved. I've got a polar plot that's similar to what I showed on the screen in the webinar, where I can see, okay, at low RPM, what is the amplitude and phase of my vibration? So I see I've got 1.41 mils of vibration at phase angle of 121.4 degrees. And I can see how that changes. And I can get to where kind of my first resonance is suspected to be. So that's this location where I've got higher levels of vibration, and then I can move to the location of my second suspected resonance again, and I can see the phase angle and the amplitude of vibration at that location. Finally, I've got a full spectrum plot plotted from that RPM range from 300 to 2000 RPM. And here you can see that I start on this particular machine with very little forward first order vibration and a small amount of negative first order vibration. And then finally, when I get into that rotational speed about where my resonance is located, I can see that I have a strong negative first order component and a weaker first order component. All of these different types of plots are available in TestLab. If I hit create a picture, I can find my orbit plot, for example, by typing in orbit. I can find my polar plot by typing in polar, and my centerline plot by typing in centerline. So these were also introduced into TestLab, I believe it was in the revision 2021.2 of the software. So if I look at this rotor dynamics tool, I choose the number of basically cycles, what we call cycles per frame. And this indicates that I'm plotting just one, or creating an orbit with one cycle of the machine. So if I go back to my navigator here and I find one of my orbit plots, this just has one basically blank spot and then a dot, which indicates that this is just one rotational cycle of the machine. That's all I had to present today. As always, if there are any other questions that comes up, my email is included in this presentation. Please don't hesitate to reach out to me. I'd be happy to help.